Morning. And welcome. What day is it today?
32.
What's
Saturday.
Saturday. So, today is the day after this crazy mofo asked me to marry him. Which, hold on. It's really mad because, we're gonna start this over, this topic.
No, it's okay. Just put your password.
I don't remember it. I need to think about it.
Oh, really? Wait. Maybe it...
It knows it, no?
Ah, yeah, it knows it. Okay.
Sorry.
Yes.
Okay.
It's working.
Great. Now we have to sign it off. Perfect. Alright, so yesterday, after I taught a full class, this crazy guy here asked me to marry him on Facebook Live.
So you can go back to day 32 and watch it.
Which, it's so crazy because, you know, we've been talking about this, like, if someone would have said to me a year ago or 6 months ago or 2 years, whenever, oh, you're going to get proposed to on Facebook, I would have been like, what?
You would have...
What are you talking about?
You would have told me this, like, before Corona, I would have laughed.
Yeah. It sounds completely ludicrous.
Yeah.
And weird, but it was so beautiful and so cute. And Adi's mom and her sisters were watching, and a bunch of the cousins and my parents watched it.
Your sister.
My sister was there, she did the class, so it really felt like, oh, in this time, you chose a really funny, really cool thing, actually.
I had to go with it.
So Adi and I are getting married.
Woohoo!
Woohoo! Yeah.
And we're gonna do a class today. 33rd day.
We're gonna do a restorative class today. Super calm. Yeah, very easy going. Both of us are quite tired, right? You're tired. Yeah. So kind of a slumbery class, as if we got up out of bed, but we didn't quite wake up yet. We're gonna just take it super easy, super calm. If you have pillows, any pillows, just take as many pillows as you can find. We're using these ones from the couch. Yeah, the ones that are on the side here, they're really big and fat. They're good. If you have yoga bolsters, of course, take them. Also straps, if you have straps or scarves. If you have this kind of style scarf that's not stretchy, that's really good. Or a tie can also work. Blocks are great. If you don't have blocks, you can use a little stack of books or sometimes little stools people have, very small ones. What else can you use as a block?
Books, you said.
Books is, it works if you have like two really fat books, because if you have too many,
too
you start
many.
To slide,
no.
Or even one really fat one would be good. Okay, let's do the morning hellos. Good morning, hello to Chiara, she's here, as most days.
Ciao, Chiara.
And Dolores is also here.
Yeah.
As most days. Good morning, birdies. We have Patrick. We have Yen. That's Yen.
Yeah, that's Yen.
Yen from Yen.
Yeah.
I call him Yen from Yasmin, but that's because that's how I kind of met him more. Anyways, good morning, Yen. Guerra Segura. Good morning. Camille and Munia.
Yeah.
Good morning.
Morning.
Both of you.
Yes.
So for those of you that haven't done yoga with me before, normally I do quite a strong class, but today we're both tired, so we're gonna do a restorative class. Super easygoing. If it's not your vibe or if you want to do a strong class, you can just go on my page. All the classes that I've done so far are there.
You can choose, there are 32 classes.
There are 32 classes so far. And I do my best to title them in such a way that you can properly find what you're looking for. And if you are into doing something really restorative today, then stay with us. But we're really gonna do a very slow, passive practice today because we want to rest a little bit. Is there anything else?
No.
Okay.
I think I already proposed yesterday, so today I don't know what to do, how to top up.
I know.
I don't know how to top what I did yesterday.
I also feel like we need to discuss this or something. I don't know.
Well, okay. I don't know. Maybe in one of the future classes there will be another big announcement.
Auntie, what are you talking about?
I don't know. I'm just saying, maybe people should stay tuned.
Seriously, this guy. It's really crazy.
Yeah.
Like, I even feel a bit like if people ask me, how did he propose to you? And I tell them, he did it on Facebook Live. I feel really weird about that, but at the same time, it was so perfect.
Exactly, because it's not just Facebook Live, it's the fact that it's the fact that it's in the corona time, you know, it was the momentum of the era that propelled it, and then I thought, okay, it just makes sense.
Yeah.
And in that sense, it's like a joke that you had to be there to understand.
Luckily, we had some people there, like Michal and Shulamit, who are
yes.
Now also there.
Hi.
Bokatov. Good morning. We are trying to start the class and at the same time doing a bit of blah blah about what happened yesterday because it was huge.
The Corona marriage.
The Corona marriage.
Yes, it is perfect, Chiara.
And Chiara, you're gonna be there for sure, right?
Oh yeah.
You better be there, girl.
You better be there.
Also Dolores.
And
of course also Shulamit and Michal.
Yeah.
Let's start. Right? Do you have something else to say?
Well,
okay, so get your mat ready. Find as many pillows around you as you can. If you can, if you have a nice couch with big fat pillows, use them. You can use the pillows from your bed, some blocks, some straps. And we're really gonna take it super easy today. Change the sound. Let's see. All right, so come to your mat. Let's start in an easy child's pose today. make sure you're warm enough because we're not going to move very much. So the body sometimes really cools down during restorative. When you go into deep relaxation, sometimes the body temperature drops a little bit. So it's good to have soft sweater. Just come into an easy child's pose with your hands on your sides. Start to breathe in through the nose, out through the mouth. Sighing your breath out very gently. Your hand palms can be facing up next to your feet. Shoulders are draping down, hanging down the back. And with every out-breath, release a little bit deeper into the front of your hips. Deep fold on the front of your hips. The abdominal muscles soft and hanging down. All the muscles of the pelvis soft and releasing down. Breathing in through the nose, out through the mouth, lengthening your in and out breaths. Let the breaths fill up your whole torso. Starting in the belly, moving all the way up to the ribs, shoulders, all the way up to the collarbones, filling up your whole torso. And as you breathe out, gently sighing, letting the full torso deflate and sink closer to the floor. Using your hands, put them next to your knees. Super slowly roll yourself up, pushing down into your hands. And every action is done with minimum tension. You keep your eyes closed through a lot of this class, feeling a bit like you're still half asleep. Tucking your toes under. Sit on top of your feet for a moment. If your small toes are not pointing forward, use your fingers to gently point them towards the front wall and just sit, releasing the weight of your pelvis onto your heels, stretching. touching the base of your toes, the soles of your feet. Minimum effort, trying to soften the front of the ankles. Maybe walking your hands a little bit behind your hips to increase the stretch. You can hang in your shoulders here. Minimum force. Few times very gently tucking your pelvis and releasing it again. Again, using the minimum amount of muscle tension, muscle force. Only the bare essential force that you need to do this movement. The rest is all relaxed and soft. Drop your pelvis back down, walk your hands forward, untuck your toes. Sit on your knees, just drop the top of your head to the right. Super gentle stretch. You can, throughout the class, play with opening and closing your eyes. We're trying to get ourselves into a half sleep kind of state, dreamy. Completely passive in the body, allowing the weight to stretch. Weight pouring down into the floor to help us stretch. If you'd like to increase this stretch, you can reach your right hand over the top of your head, over your left ear. And again, using gravity, so you hold your hand over your face and then you just drop the elbow down. No pulling on the head, just dropping the weight down into the floor. Inducing a dreamy kind of sleepy kind of state. Move your hand more to the back of your head and turn the chin towards the right armpit. Again, minimum tension, dropping the elbow down using gravity. And if it's too intense, just release the hand and stretch only with the weight of the head. Come out of this, gently push the back of your neck into your hand to come up. A little bit of resistance, drop the hand, then drop the top of your head to the left side. Keeping your whole face soft and relaxed. Hanging, your jaw maybe slightly opening and hanging to the left. Drop any expression in the face. And if you'd like to increase a little bit, reach your left hand up and over, place it on top of your right ear, and then drop the left shoulder down, the left elbow down to the floor. Not pulling on your head, but using the weight of the elbow to gently guide your head a little bit more down. chin towards the left armpit, and then put the hand on the back of your head. Again, redrop the shoulder and the elbow. Minimum effort here. Maybe a little bit of pressure in the fingertips to hold on to the head, but that's all the force you need. Gently push the back of your head into the hand. Bring your head back upright, drop your hand. Bring your face back to the middle, drop the chin to the chest. Super gentle. And this is enough of a stretch for you, just stay there. If you'd like to increase, clasp your hands. Same idea, a little bit of effort in the fingers to stay together, but the elbows drop, the shoulders drop. Super gentle. If it's too intense, you can move the hands a little bit more up or down, depending on where you feel the most stretch. Just experiment a little bit. Find a place where you can be calm, relaxed, breathing, soft, dreamy. Come out by gently pressing the back of your head into your hands, then release the hands. Roll your shoulders very slowly, lazily, a few times. Changing direction. Find a block. Come to lying on your back. Take a block with you, or a pillow if you don't have a block. Start with the block on the lowest position. Your legs are long. Put the block, the base of the block, so the bottom of the block underneath your bottom ribs. Legs are long, dropping your head back. If it's too intense for your neck here, you can put a pillow underneath your head. Just very gently opening up the rib cage. Completely releasing the neck. Your hands can be by your sides with the palms facing up. Feet are falling out. And your rib cage is falling open. Breathing into the front of the ribs. Releasing the top of your neck, letting your head sink into the floor or pillow. jaw soft and relaxed, your pelvis sinking down into the floor. Then you can start to open the arms a little bit more to the sides. Very gentle opening through the front of the chest. Keeping your attention in the body. If you feel your mind starting to wander, just very gently bring your awareness back into your breath and into any sensation. Peeling off layer after layer of holding. Every out-breath releasing a little bit more into the floor. Soften the space between your eyebrows. Release the back of your neck. If you'd like to increase slightly more, you can take your hands up above your head. Maybe clasping thumbs together for a moment, straightening through the elbows and then letting the elbows drop down, seeing where your arms end up. Letting the elbows pour down to the floor, releasing the armpits, the collarbone, the shoulder blades. Keep releasing. Maybe your arms are sliding more and more back down. Slide your arms all the way back down. Step your feet in a little bit. All of this with the laziest, most effortless energy. Lift your pelvis just as much off the floor as you need. Take the block out from underneath your back. Put your back on the floor. Lengthen your legs. feet flopping open, the hands can lie wherever they're comfortable. Noticing any ripple effects from lying on the block, any reverberations in the body. Just notice them. In all of these poses, we try to find very calm, still positions, calm, still energy. We see what happens when we just stay there. We don't adjust, we don't fiddle with anything. And let the body unfold itself. Let the body tell you what it's doing. And just witness it. Start to bring your right knee into the chest as lazily as you can. Very gently. Minimum effort holding the right knee. Keep the front of your left thigh soft. Closed. If your head is comfy on your little pillow, keep it there and just see if you find a position of the knee where it's resting, where you don't have to hold it there, where you can use a very, very small amount of effort in the arms to just let your knee fall closer to you. Releasing the inner thighs, releasing the whole pelvis, with it. Keep noticing. You might find that every time you think it's released, a next door opens and a next option becomes available. A deeper release becomes available to you. Just notice it. Enjoy the way. Start to let your knee fall a little bit open to the right, but keep your left hip grounded. Start to lean your right elbow into the floor. Very subtle shift. Your knee is only slightly to the right. Your right elbow leaning into the floor. And then pull your knee in a little bit closer. Back to the middle, your right elbow comes off the floor, and then take the knee gently over to the left, very soft, very small movement. repeat this a few times, moving side to side with the knee. Finding easier and easier ways of doing this small, it's not even a half circle, it's like a quarter of a circle or a third of a circle of the knee. When you get to the outside, let the right elbow lean in the floor. When you get to the inside, let both shoulders release. Maybe your head starts to roll a little bit. Take it super easily and see if you can take the knee up and over. So when the knee comes over the middle, you're pulling it closer and closer into your chest. Releasing all the hip flexor muscles, very soft, as if the bones and the joints are just rolling with nothing in between them. No tension, no effort. Gently let it fizzle out. Come back to the middle. And just notice if anything has changed since beginning this posture. Find your strap or your scarf. Take away the pillow from underneath your head. If you have a strap, loop it in a very big, so that you have a lot of space.
Because of the head,
So I've been doing this posture a few times recently because I really like it. We're gonna put the back of the head into a strap or a scarf, and then the ball of the right foot into the other end. And Adi has a really nice way of tying his two scarves together, and then he makes like a hammock for his head. It's maybe even more comfortable than a strap, I think, what he's doing.
Mm-hmm.
So we use this stretch both for the leg and for the back of the neck. So start with really a bent right knee and see how far you need to bend the leg so the leg is really fully relaxed. You can adjust the height of the strap, and especially make sure that the strap is really around the base of your skull, not too low around the neck, so your back of your neck is really long and you're taking the full weight of the head with the leg. Really nice, really unusual feeling, because we're so used to carrying our heads around all day. I like it, Adi.
I mean, if I really relax, it takes me here. Like, I really let go of everything.
Yeah.
But then it's like
It's a bit too much on the neck, huh?
Yeah, it's a bit much on this side of the neck. But
and I think that with you it works because you have this big scarf. So so maybe there's a slight amount of tension needed in the right leg to keep the leg up, but make it really, really minimal. It also depends a bit on where you have the strap on the foot, I think. So for a moment, keeping the right leg bent, just really allow your head to fall completely back into your strap or scarf. And if you haven't managed to find a way to strap yourself like this, if you don't have a scarf or a strap, just use, if you have a shorter scarf or strap, use your hands here to start to stretch the leg. If you have a way of connecting the head and the foot like this, I really recommend it. It may look weird or awkward, but it feels really great. It really allows your shoulders to sink down into the floor, and the back of your neck to be completely long. And then while we keep the head fully, fully relaxed and sinking down, we start to really gently move towards straightening the right knee. I say move towards because it's not so important it's straightened all the way. Aiming to keep the knee where it is and just extend the lower leg. Very gentle counter push against the strap. Really minimal, minimal effort here. Only straightening the knee as far as you can without tensing. And while keeping the upper thigh in the same place. Gently release your head out of the strap and start using your hands. So take your hands on either side. Walk your hands as close as you can to the foot. And then only holding the tension in the fingers, release the shoulders down. Let your shoulders hang down into the floor. The only things working are your fingers to hold onto the strap. Your knee can still be slightly bent. You can experiment a bit with the amount of flex in the foot, increasing the stretch behind your calf. And if it feels good and easy to you, again, you can work towards straightening the leg. Maybe a few times bending and straightening very slowly. Now your head is on the floor, but try to maintain the same feeling as if your head is being carried by a hammock. Super soft, shoulders very soft, hanging down. Minimum effort, elbows hanging down. Just the hands with the fingertips grabbing onto the strap. Just as much tension as they need. As little as possible. And then grabbing one of your blocks, if you have one, put it on your right side, on the highest level. Using your right hand. Please start with using the left hand so we have a bit of counter. Left hand holding the strap, right hand is holding on the outside of the thigh, the right drop your right foot towards the right. Your knee can be slightly bent. Slowly letting go bit by bit of the strap so the leg can fall more and more down. Take it in small steps, making sure that your left hip stays down and grounded. Your left hip isn't coming off the floor. And then you can place your block somewhere below your right thigh. See if you find a spot where your thigh can lean onto the block. Depending on your flexibility, how close the block needs to be to the torso. And then really letting your leg lean onto the block. You can change hands now. So the right hand can hold onto the strap. Left hand opening so that your whole back is still flat on the floor. Really letting your right leg lean into the block. Be as passive as possible. Slight bend in the knee. Distance of your block, also the height of your block, depends on the flexibility in your hip. And be very honest with yourself, keeping the front of the left hip grounding down. Your left hip is not coming off the floor. Your right leg leaning into the block, completely passive. Maybe after a little while you can move the block a bit more down the leg once your hip is opened up. Very slowly, gently letting the leg come deeper down. Maybe even grabbing onto the right foot with the right hand, letting go of the strap. Again, minimum effort, trying to use only the hand here, the left shoulder still. Drop the right shoulder, dropping into the floor. Deeper. Reach your left hand now to the ball of the right foot. Take your foot a little bit higher up and closer to you. Maybe crawling your head on top of your left elbow. You can still find a place for the block here to support this. Leaning your head into your left armpit. And then super gently let go of this bend, the right knee. Pull the knee back into the chest for a moment. And then let go of the knee, lengthen your right leg down. Closing your eyes, dropping your palms over. Noticing. to move your left knee up super, super lazily, grabbing onto the left knee. And really take it very slowly, letting both hips sink down to the floor. Minimum effort. Letting the weight of the elbows guide your knee further down towards the chest. Keep breathing deeply and find more and more and more levels of passiveness here. Every time you release the hip a little bit more, a new door opens. Something more can fall, can soften, and release down deep inside the hips, deep inside the shoulders. Super gently start to just let your knee fall a little bit more open to the left until your left elbow reaches the floor, leans into the floor. Hang out there for a moment, letting the weight of the knee drop into your left elbow, releasing the right elbow, releasing both shoulders. Curling the tail, releasing the pelvis down. And then pulling your knee gently back towards the middle, very slowly. It can be very small, this movement. Finding a balance of effort between your hands and your elbows and your shoulders. Start to pull the knee a little bit over to the right. It can be very, very small. Every out breath releasing more and more and more. Play a little bit between these two points, circling the knee up and over to the outside, very slow, letting it fall and seeing how that creates a chain reaction in the rest of your spine. Maybe your head starts to roll a little bit side to side. Take it very slow and easily, lazily, like you're sleeping. Every time you move the leg, find more relaxation, easier way. Like your bones are just swimming in a soft, soft soup. Effortlessly gliding. And then slowly. slowly let the movement fizzle out, come back into the middle. Take your time. Stay there a moment. Find your strap or your scarf. And wrap it around the ball of your foot. And the back of your neck, base of your skull. Make sure the head is very supported. Your head isn't falling back. Start with a very bent left knee. Maybe the side is different than the other. Let your head completely fall into the support. Belly is soft, you're not using your abdominal muscles. And then if you're ready, start to very, very slowly, very gently work towards straightening the left knee. Keeping your head hanging. Not important that the knee straightens all the way. Keep releasing the belly, the pelvis, the back of the neck. Shoulders are pouring down into the floor. If you're with a straight or close to straight leg, you can play a little bit with the amount of flex in the foot, which in turn plays with the amount of stretch on the back of the neck. Flexing the foot brings the head a bit down. Unflexing brings the head a bit more up. To your foot with both hands, release your head down so the head is on the floor, but we're trying to maintain the feeling of this supported neck, relaxed neck. Grab as close as you can to the foot with the hands and then drop your shoulders down. The whole weight of the hand, the whole weight of the arms is hanging down from the strap, which pulls your leg closer. So you're not pulling with muscular tension or with effort. You're allowing both arms to fall down. Working gently towards straightening your left leg. You can play a little bit with straightening and bending the leg. And play with the amount of flex in the foot. Really keeping those arms hanging. Keeping the back of the neck soft, soft, soft. Keeping the front of the right thigh soft. drop your left leg towards the left, leaning it into your left hand. So the left elbow is leaning into the floor. And you're gently, gently releasing your leg down. Keeping your right hip flat on the floor. Taking really small steps to drop this leg. And then you can find a position where the leg can lean into the block. Place the block as high on the thigh as you need to allow the leg to fully relax while the right leg is still, the right hip is still leaning into the floor. You can change hands, so hold the strap with the left hand now, open the right hand to the side, encouraging your whole right side to stay grounded as the left leg drops more and more into the block. Position with as little effort as possible. No holding in the groin. We're passively stretching this leg. Strap. You're using the support underneath the left leg. And if it's easy for you, you can use a lower level of the block. Having the block underneath the leg really allows the leg to fall down. If you want to go a little bit deeper, you can reach the left foot with the right hand, grabbing the ball of the foot. You can still use the block, maybe using it, moving it a little bit up, and sneak your head into the right armpit, moving the block a little bit up. Releasing the weight of the head into the right armpit. Keep the right hip flexor soft. Whole left hip soft. Breathing. Then very gently go. Start to bend your knee back in. Really slowly grab the knee. Pull it into your chest. Releasing your shoulders down. Legs long. a moment to notice how your body feels, how your hips feel. Super lazily roll to one side. Push yourself up to sitting. Super lazy. Now take a block. Make sure you have as many pillows as you have near, that you have them close by. Take your biggest, strongest pillow. If you have a block, lean the pillow on the block like this. Right?
What is it? Why are you asking me?
Just the stretch you want to do.
Oh, no.
Not like this?
No, you leave the poster and you put this one here.
Ah, okay, sorry. Put your big pillow flat. So your knees are really together, right?
Yeah. Knees are really together. And then you pick up your pelvis, tuck it under, and place it back down.
Using the fingertips, picking up your pelvis, tucking it, and placing your butt on the block.
Yeah. And then starting to go backwards.
Then laying back onto your pillows. Maybe putting even an extra pillow under your head. Finding a place where you can really rest. We're going to stay here for a little while. And if you find that you don't have enough support in your lower back, don't suffer through these poses. The whole point is that you can be fully, fully relaxed. So if you don't have enough support, you can put another pillow.
It's really important that the pelvis would be tucked under. So the stretch goes to the back, to the front of the legs, front of the knees, instead of stressing the lower back.
Mm-hmm.
So when you tuck under and point your sit bones towards the knees, then your lower back releases the tension, and then you'll have more of a stretch here in the front. And this is really a stretch to the front of the knees.
For me, it is quite a bit of stress on the lower back, actually.
Yeah, so if you're here, you can tuck under again.
I mean, I'm not... This is as tucked as it gets.
So maybe you need another block. Or a higher block.
Under the pelvis.
Yeah. I put back the higher block. The pelvis.
Right, so it's a little bit figuring out what works for you before you can really relax into this. If you don't have the right position yet, really make sure that you keep searching. If you don't have blocks really here, you can use books and maybe a little blanket over the top of the books. Close your eyes, you can open your arms to the side. Thank you.
here in front of the knee. No.
Maybe rounding your back forward for a moment. Stretches are not about finding your maximum and staying there for a long time and suffering. It's really about finding a soft, relaxed place where you can stay for a while and feel good. And your body will fall open because it's relaxed. Place your hands on top of your hips to send a bit of extra softening encouragement. Really consciously releasing any holding in the pelvis. Releasing the top of your neck, back of your neck. Jaw. Mm-hmm. allowing your body to drift here, half asleep, half awake. Falling open, unraveling. If you want to add a little stretch to the top of your back, reach your arms to the side and all the way up. And then let your hands drop down behind your head, elbows falling open, armpits falling open. Yourself to come back to sitting upright. You can grab onto your straps, pull yourself up lazily. And then once you're upright, take your feet out of the strap. Now your hips and your feet. That's great. Mine is not long enough. So if you have a really long strap, you can use it like this and wrap it all the way around your feet. If your strap is not long enough, like mine, just grab it, just wrap it around the balls of both feet. So your heels are in line with your sit bones, your feet are hip width apart. Tighten the strap as much as you need so that your feet fall in line with your legs. This is just to prevent your feet from flopping open. So your legs are hip width apart. And you're just using the strap so your feet don't flop open and your legs can stay parallel. And then you can use however many pillows you'd like, or however many pillows you need to really lay your head down over your legs, lay your torso down over your legs and be fully relaxed. It can also be nice to place a block just between your legs to rest your head onto it. Again, it's a little bit searching for the thing that worked for you. If one block is too low, you can have two blocks, or you can have a block and a pillow on the top. Make sure you find a position where you feel very comfortable, very relaxed. So the outsides of your feet are leaning into the strap so your whole legs can be relaxed without flopping open. Your head is resting on a block or pillow or both. Elbows, the weight of your elbows is pouring down into the floor. Shoulder blades are sliding down the back on each side. Your hip flexor muscles are completely soft and relaxed. There's no effort here whatsoever to be in this pose. Belly is soft. Release. Tailbone uncurling, pelvis soft and hanging down. Unraveling, unwinding. With every out breath, another new door opens, another bit of holding releases. Peeling off layer after layer after layer of effort. Dropping your head down, down, down. Allowing your head to be fully supported. Thank you. you feel yourself sinking down so much that you can take away some of the support and still be this relaxed, go for it. Go a little bit deeper into the pose. Relaxing the outside of your leg, the IT bands are completely soft. No tension, no effort. For the last minute or so, take away your supports. Maybe one of them, maybe all of them. Keep the strap around the feet, but let your torso hang. Let your head hang down. Let the gravity pull you down. All we have to do is not resist the gravity. Release the resistance. Sinking down.
Thank you.
city. Maybe roll through your neck a little bit. Remove the strap. Bolster or two big pillows, put it a little bit on the left side of your of the front of your mat. Take your right foot forward from an all fours and your left leg walking a bit back, then walking your left your right ankle all the way until you have it against bolster, maybe your bolster even comes a little bit on top of the foot. Aiming to put your left hip down onto the bolster. And you can also support the left knee with one or more pillows. So it's like we're creating a gap for the right leg, and the rest of the body is a little bit higher than the right leg supported. Put your left ear on top of the bolster. Supported pigeon pose. Again, take a moment to really find a position that is comfortable where you can stay for a while. If you need to adjust anything, do it now. You can have your left hand, your left elbow resting on the bolster. Your shoulders sliding a little bit away from each other, pouring down into the floor. And belly resting on the bolster, on the pillows. Allowing the full weight of your body to be supported by the floor. Find a position for your head that's comfortable. Breathing into any tight areas. Letting the pose expose itself to you, letting the body show you. Just staying there calmly and observing. We're so used in more active styles of yoga to put our bodies in a position with a lot of effort. There's nothing wrong with that, it's just a different style. But in this more restorative type yoga, we really try to use no effort at all. Let the body fall. Observing the body almost a little bit as if you're a scientist. Observing what happens without judging anything, without expecting anything. just noticing and letting it be. Prepare yourself to come out of this very gently, very lazily. Creating a gap for the left shin so that the whole body is supported and the left shin can fall down, making any adjustments you might need. You can have your right cheek on the edge, hopefully, of the bolster, so your head is kind of between being turned to the side and turned to the front. It's a bit in the middle. Your right elbow hanging off the pillow. Left shoulder hanging down the pillow. Shoulder blades sliding down the back on each side. Your jaw soft. Maybe your mouth falling slightly open. Releasing the pelvis, uncurling the tailbone, softening the front of the right thigh and the your neck, releasing. Stay here very still, very quiet, observing your body, unraveling, peeling off layer after layer. Every out-breath, something else new releases, relaxes, opening another door for deeper relaxation to happen. Just observe this process. Yourself to come out of this very gently, lazily. Back.
25.
Oh, perfect. It's a portage of asana with a bolster underneath your back. You can have a pillow under your head. If it feels good, you can also have a pillow underneath your knees. Oh, that's good. That looks great. Letting your pelvis sink down. Arms can be wherever it feels good to you. If it feels nice to have them a bit wide and open, go for it. Otherwise, rest them next to your body, or you can have them resting together on your belly or on your chest. Giving your body some time to process what it's been through in the past 2 hours. In this sleepy, dreamy, stretchy world. Unraveling. Unveiling, revealing anything that wants to show itself to you. Allowing your body to tell you. Let your body fall open. See if you can spread your awareness all over the whole body. Become aware of every little square millimeter of skin at once. All of your muscles and tendons. Your fingernails and your hair and your toenails. All of your veins and your blood, your inner organs, your digestive tract, your lungs, your heart, your liver, all of your bones, all of your cells, continually moving and working and multiplying and dying. Your whole body constantly working and moving, changing, adjusting. Resting here as long as you like. And as always, I would like to thank you so much for joining. I hope that this felt as good to you as it did to me. It was really what I needed today. Enjoy the feeling of relaxation in the body. See See if you can carry it along with you into your day. And I hope to see you again tomorrow morning. You have no more announcements to make.
Well, actually.
No.
No.
No more announcements for the rest of the day. Oh wow, it started to rain.
Yeah, today is a rainy day.
Hmm. Well, it's a good day to stay home then.
Yeah.
Have a beautiful day. See you tomorrow.